Yo, what have I gotten myself into? Who am I? What am I doing? What's the dealio? What's going on? I don't even know anymore. Hold on, get it together. This is CPA Strength. I am the strongest licensed CPA in the state of Florida. What do? I motivate, educate, and inspire by teaching accounting basics, building blocks on a daily basis over here. So come join me if you haven't. If you're new here, subscribe because it's lots of fun, a lot of teaching. I've helped thousands upon thousands of people learn accounting. I'm gonna show you over here if you happen to be new. If you happen to not be one of my bingers. This is the best playlist in the world, best accounting playlist in the world. It'll make all your dreams come true. It'll make all your food not have any calories in it, so that's really important. And also find a companionship if you're looking for that. So really, a one-stop shop, basically, is what I'm trying to say. I have a classic series. Classic series. Dang it. Dang it, man. This is my classic series, right? Number 67 of the classic series. Can't believe I'm on 67 already. Can't believe it. Oof. It's hot in here. I was having a bad hair day, but it's hot. So, we're just going to have to listen to the hair comments because it's too hot to have a hat on right now. So anyways, number 67. It's going to be fixed and variable costs. We're going to talk about fixed and variable costs. Let's go. Let's get into this. Now we're gonna zone in. It's me and my squad, my DCAler squad, my Get My Chippers Up gang. What up? Now this, I know what you're gonna say. Oh, this isn't financial accounting. We do financial accounting. Look, this is accounting basics. This is a managerial accounting, but I get so many more in all the comments. I do have a lot of people in college taking financial accounting, but there's also gonna be some people in college taking managerial accounting. This is managerial accounting, so we're gonna do some videos on managerial accounting because that's what I feel like doing for right now. Also, you know, if you're starting up a small business, so I do have quite a few small business owners that watch this, or people are trying to get a job, and this might be in one of their job interviews. So this is just a good thing to have. It's just a good knowledge base to have, and I think it's real life because I've used this before. I was always doing, you know, break-even analysis and stuff, and like, how many widgets do I have to sell to make some money, you know, to break even? Because I got my rent, I got my car insurance, you know, I got gas, and that's a variable cost, and blah 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 blah. Fixed and variable costs. Now let me just try to run through this, and hopefully I can explain everything between the fixed and variable costs. All right. In these examples, we have actually my, you know, a stripped down bare bones Dorn CPA LLC, taxed as an S corp. I like that hybrid. You know what I'm saying? Fixed costs stay the same, no matter how many tax returns we sell. All right, like the rent. This is per month. The rent's going to be $400 a month, whether we sell. Here's our little chart down here. Okay, here's our expenses, and here's our tax returns. So here's our fixed cost down here. It's the same no matter how many tax returns we sell. And like, we could sell 0 to 6 tax returns, and our fixed costs are always going to be $600, right? Because rent, doesn't matter if we sell 0 or 6 tax returns, our rent's still gonna be $400. Then we got our Wi-Fi or our internet. It doesn't matter how many tax returns we sell, 0 or 6 tax returns, it's still, the Wi-Fi is still gonna be $100. Same as the phone, that's a fixed cost. It's fixed, it stays the same, it's fixed. Doesn't matter for our cost, doesn't matter if we sell 0 or 6 of them, it's gonna be fixed. If you no matter how many you sell, it's still gonna be $600. Now here's the fun of this is the variable costs. Now look, our rent $400, Wi-Fi $100, and phone $100, $600 a month of fixed costs. We sell we sell zero tax returns. We still have to pay rent. We still have to pay our Wi-Fi. We still have to pay our phone. So we're out $600. Variable costs. Look, I underlined under vary, and for variable costs, it vary upon how many sold. All right, so you can kind of, you know, variable, fixed. It's fixed. It's done. It's over with. Variable, vary, varies. It varies on how many I sell. Varies. So on our case, our variable cost is tax preparation software, which costs $50 per return. It's the software where I can put my stuff in, and it's really worth it to me, because if I had to do a tax return by hand without the software, it would take me so much time. It would take me days, so it's worth it to me. That's our variable cost, and that costs $50 per tax return. And now the other thing, so that's all our costs. That's all our costs we have. We have our fixed costs that aren't going to change. And then we only do one thing, we sell tax returns. And every tax return we sell, it costs us $50 on top of the fixed costs. That's our variable costs. We sell tax returns for $200. All right, that's our selling price for $200. So really you've got your costs and your revenue. So now you've got to figure out stuff. I mean, you got to figure out you have a certain amount of money in the bank. You got to say, hey, like, you know, how many tax returns can I do if I don't do any tax returns? How many months can I stay in business? But that's fixed costs, you know. And let's say I do a couple. Like how many tax, you know, and this is a huge one, really, is a break even point. It's like, how many tax returns do I have to do per month to break even, to have my revenue equal my costs? See, that's super important, right? And everyone's in business to make money, so you want to know what your break-even point is, and do a couple more than that. You know, before you get in any business, you should really figure out this break-even point, because it's like, if I'm doing this and my break-even point is like, say, 40 tax returns in a month, and there's no way I can do that many tax returns in a month. You know, like, the most I can do is 20 tax returns, then my business model is not going to work. These are fixed costs in purple. Then I went to I made variable costs in blue here. I thought that would be nice to have the variable costs in blue. And I made this nice little graph. So let's just go with the graph. We already did, let's go with tax returns. We sell zero tax returns. That's all fixed costs then of $600. And that's how much our costs are to produce zero tax returns. And then we sold zero tax returns, so our revenue is $0. So we're in the hole $600 now. But what happens if we do one tax return? One tax return, well, you're gonna have all of the $600 fixed costs. But one tax return, it's gonna cost you $50 additional, because that's how much the tax software costs. So for one tax return, you're gonna have $650 of costs. 600 fixed, 50 variable, and then you're gonna make $200. So one tax return, you're gonna be in the hole $450. What happens when you sell two tax returns? Well, $600 of fixed costs, of course. Now two tax returns is gonna be an extra $100, $50 each of variable costs. It's gonna be $100 of variable costs. And then if you sell two tax returns, it's gonna be $700 in costs, 600 fixed, 100 variable, and then you're gonna have $400. So you're gonna be in the hole $300. So you're in the hole a little bit less every time you sell one, with how our factors are going. Let's see, what happens when you sell, we sell three tax returns that month? Again, $600 of fixed costs, then three tax returns, that's gonna be $50 each, $150 for variable costs. So three, boom, 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 yeah, $750, it's gonna cost you $750. and then you're gonna make $600. Then you're gonna make $600. So you're only in the hole $150. What happens when you sell? What happens when you sell four tax returns? $600 in fixed costs, and then four. Well, we have $50 each in tax software variable costs. That's $200 more in variable costs. So boom, 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 boom. That's going to be $800. See, you have $600 in fixed, $400 in variable. And look at this. And you sold four, and now you've made $800. So four is our break-even point. Four is our break-even point. So that's important to know, right? Break even for four. All right, but we're trying to at least get some money to take my girl out to that 2 for $20 Applebee's. I mean, at least, right? I mean, she's like, all you do is work and then you lose money. What sense does that make? Exactly. So, but we gotta at least sell four. We gotta at least sell four to not lose money, or, you know, if we sell three, we're not losing that much money. You get the gist. It's just you need to figure this out when you're starting a business. Let's say you sell five tax returns. Now hopefully we're gonna make a profit, right? Because if we just broke even, because look, our fixed costs were the same, right? And here comes the stuff. Our fixed costs were the same. We just broke even on four. So now with one tax return, we make $200, right? We're making $200, but we have a variable cost of 50. So for every unit we make above and beyond the fixed costs, we make $150 profit. So I assume that now we're gonna make we were broken even at four units sold. Now with five units sold, look, we're gonna make $150 profit. And then with six, $300 profit. But let's just finish the chart up. With five, look, $600 in fixed cost, boom, 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 five times five for our variable cost, for our tax return software, that's gonna be an extra $250. So $850 is our costs. And then if we sell five tax returns at $200 each, that's $1,000. So see, four we were broken even. Now we sell five, and now we've made $150 in profit. What about when we sell six? Still $600 for fixed costs. You get the point now. I've tried to, you know, abuse you with the fixed costs. You get the fixed costs. They don't change. So now we've sold six tax returns this month. $50 each variable cost. It's going to be $300 more in variable costs. So we have $900 total, six, and then $900 total of costs. And look, we made another $150 profit, and a total we've made $300 profit for the month. Every unit we sell, we're gonna make $150 more now of profit every unit we sell. So once we hit that break-even point, it's like let's get our chippers up, you know. Deuces.